So, I'm not really sure if everyone here in the room knows Kermit, the little green frog, but he's singing, "It's not easy being green. It's not easy being green." And actually, it isn't. It is quite complex. But probably 8 out of 10 people here in the room want to be more green, want to adopt a more sustainable lifestyle because he or she is seriously concerned with climate change. But 7 out of the same 10 people have no clue where to start, or how to get going. And that's a problem. And to illustrate it, I'm going to just take the very easy example of coffee. Who had already had coffee today? Voila. So, drinking coffee has become a whole new way of living, right? It's been adopted by many hipsters, and also a little bit by myself. But did you know that actually drinking coffee has the same ecological footprint than drinking 10 cups of tea? And that doesn't mean that, because I realize that the break is coming up now, right, that you have to start pinpointing to all people that will order a coffee over the break. But it illustrates the fact that it's not easy being green. It is quite complex, actually. And to go a little bit deeper on that, I'm going to take you back to the year 1982. So in that year, Italy won the World Cup soccer. Very important event. But much more importantly, we still needed one planet. One planet. Meaning that at the end of the year, all carbon we emitted together, I was just born in that year, so mine was a little bit smaller, but if we took all that carbon, it was still absorbed by natural forest and water. Now, some of us grew a little bit older, including myself and Martin, my co-founder, who should be here somewhere in the room. But much more importantly, we also seamlessly evolved into a situation where we needed 1.2, almost 2 planets. And today, we actually even need a staggering 4. 4 planets. Which means that at the end of this year, our Earth will need an additional 3 years to recover from all the things we did together during these exciting 12 months. And if there are Dutch people in the room, they're doing a little bit better, 3.5. And if there are US people in the room, they're doing a little bit worse. 5 planets. Right? But again, the question is, why aren't we doing something about it? And a not-so-stupid person once said that actually, in order to start doing good, the first thing what you need to do is start knowing what good actually is. And to illustrate that a little bit better, I'm going to introduce you to Steven. And Steven is a very nice guy. I really like Steven. Steven is also a healthy guy. He's what you would say a flexitarian. So that means he eats fish, meat, and a lot of veggies. He has a nice house in the city center of Amsterdam, but it's not very well insulated. And he has a great job. He's an impact investor. So that means that he travels the world to find social enterprises and help them grow. But he flies the plane doing so. So, if everybody would be nice guy Steven, we still need 4 planets. Nice guy Steven, good intentions, 4 planets. So how can we help nice guy Steve in order to improve? And that's what we try to do with For Good. So we have developed a mobile application that uses 2017 technology and data to do what actually Socrates already said so many years ago. We help people to understand in a very simple way what their ecological footprint is, what their personal ecological footprint is, the consequence of their everyday actions, such as ordering a cup of coffee during the break at TEDx Antwerp. Because actually, 75% of your footprint is coming from 3 things. The first one being how you move. And what we do is we use all sensor technology, which is already available in your smartphone, to understand how you move. All the data that is generated by sensors, accelerometers, barometers, vibrating stuff. We use that to apply deep learning techniques to understand if you're taking a walk, you're riding a bike, you're driving the car, you're in a plane upwards, or you're reading a book in the train. And we calculate the ecological footprint of your everyday actions. And we bring that in a simple way to you. This is the footprint of your mobility profile. Also, the second one is energy usage. Energy usage at home. You can enter your energy usage, or you can just simply link up to a smart meter. All the data generated and that will be generated every day more and more in your home, we will interpret and in a very easy way explain you, hey, how many planets do you need if everybody would have your home? Thirdly, it's about consumption. Based upon routine-based contextual questions, we try to understand what your consumption pattern is. Because everybody has a routine, a morning routine, a weekend routine, a sleeping routine, a party routine. And based upon smart interventions, we will ask you, hey, you're going out, how many beers are we having? Or is it gin tonight? Is it gin o'clock? And based upon that, we have measurement points that we feed back to you. Hey, this is the ecological profile of your everyday gin, okay? And all these things together add up to a profile that can help you to improve on your ecological footprint. So if we bring that back to Nice Guys team, Nice Guys Steven now, on a weekly basis, is taking one day a vegetarian meal. The same week, once, he's trading the car for a bike in order to drive to the office. And a couple of times a year, he's not taking the plane, but the train in going to London or Paris conventions. And he's reading a book while doing so. And it's actually by doing this that Steven is able to reduce his yearly global CO2 footprint with 2.2 tons of CO2, which is around 20%. And it's now actually, thank you, Hero Steven, Planet Hero Steven, because if everybody now would be Steven, then we would actually get to the Paris Convention climate goals in keeping our planet warming below 2 degrees. And I think there are a lot of Stevens in the world. I hope there are a lot of Stevens here in the room, that they're walking here on the marketplace, that they're walking in the park, although it's raining a little bit today. And if you go out for the break right now, apart from the fact that ordering coffee is to be reconsidered potentially, there is two things which I would like you to know. First thing is there are a million ways of starting to adopt a more sustainable lifestyle. A million ways, and every way is a good way. And furthermore, it will enrich your life, it will not make it less worthy to live. And secondly, it's very important to just start. To just start. Because every small step of everybody here in the room is actually a very big deal. Thank you very much.